Forex exchange fees are really high. So try not to necessarily use the banks. There are a lot of Forex exchange companies out there that can assist you with much cheaper rates. Hi everyone, my name is Ajay Wasserman and I am the founder of the FIO Group. In my previous video, I talked about different types of savings in a domestic level. Today, I'm going to share with you the international savings models that we can use as South Africans to invest outside of this country. So first of all, step one is you would have to convert any funds that you have in rands to the different currency that you need to convert it to. And for that, we normally use a forex exchange company. Now, a lot of people try to do that via the banks, and you would have to get approval from the Reserve Bank and also tax clearance that you are allowed to invest that money overseas. Using the banks can become really expensive. Forex exchange fees are really high. So try not to necessarily use the banks. There are a lot of Forex exchange companies out there that can assist you with much cheaper rates on the Forex exchange. If you need any information on that, please click on the link below and I can give you the links to the Forex exchange companies that can assist with the exchange. Once your money has been converted to the Forex currency of your choice, or that by advice from your independent financial advisor who has given you the advice to convert it to a certain currency and then move it into an international investment where it sits in that currency with fund managers or on list platforms like Investec and Allan Gray that do have Orbis international fund managers and other investment managers that can manage your funds overseas within those funds, investing into different asset classes like equity and bonds and derivatives and everything overseas you can get access to, as well as share trading portfolios that can be done by qualified financial advisors depending on how big your investment portfolio is. With international investments, you should look at the tax implications that can have on your South African estate as well as your South African income tax portfolio. You don't want to pay unnecessary taxes with your offshore investments, and you have to look at things like CITES tax. That is a form of estate tax that can push up your estate duty taxes when you pass away and your spouse is supposed to get all that money back or leave it in the offshore investment in another country. There will be a form of CITES tax that can be applied on UK and US listed shares. So be careful of the double taxation agreements. Make sure that your tax planning is done properly by a registered tax professional that can assist you with this advice, as well as an independent financial advisor. On your offshore investments, there's different types of investments as well. You get the discretionary side of investments that draws taxes to the discretionary side, and you also get sinking funds. Sinking funds can be used as a tax benefit where the fund will be taxed, or the investment will be taxed with inside the investment. So please make sure that you do proper homework before going for international investment options and talk to your independent financial advisor. Thank you for watching this video. I don't want you to miss anything, so please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like me on Facebook, connect with me on LinkedIn, and follow me on SoundCloud and Instagram.